for really witnessing history, the school's first ever musical. The students have worked super hard. Our administration has been super supportive through the whole process. We're so thankful that you're here. As you can see, we have quite a few people back in concessions. Feel free to take this time to grab your popcorn, grab your soda. We're going to delay just 5 minutes to get everybody seated so we can start in the right place. Thank you so much for being here. Again, take this time to please put your cell phone on vibrate or silent. This show is being professionally recorded by Mr. Doylette. Let's give it up for Mr. Doylette. And again, we'll start in about 5 minutes once everybody gets through the line, and then we'll get going. Thank you so much for being here.
Although he had everything his heart desired, he was spoiled, selfish, and unkind.
But then one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold.
The pulse by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away.
But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within.
And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress.
The prince tries to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and used a powerful spell in the castle.
Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside of the castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world.
The rose she had offered him was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years.
Amen. Each of lives help another, and our true love in return, by the last help of them, the spell that then is broken.
If not, he'd be doomed to remain a beast.
Oh, Jesus.
As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope.
For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Medical spells.
You like it all that much, it's yours. But sir, I insist.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
And I fell in a town that's only she, but as beautiful as me. So I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle.
But there he goes, he's an angel. What's your star?
Oh, he's so cute!
Still, my heart, I want it real. He's such a tall, dark, strong, and handsome.
Brass!
Bye-bye.
Be careful.
Go with that.
dark forest.
This way, or this way.
Maurice raced towards a nearby castle.
One bolt plunged at Maurice, grabbing the scarf right off his neck.
Yeah.
father. He must have happened to him.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Couldn't keep quiet, just had to invite him to stay.
I was trying to be invisible.
Rubbish!
Conway, can you blame me for trying to maintain the commands we have left? Look at us! Look at you.
Oh, right.
If the master doesn't find a way to break us down, slowly, but surely, we'll all come to you. Thanks.
Hold on, Lumiere. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Hello, is anyone here?
It's a girl! This is the one, the girl we've been waiting for. She's come to break the spell.
Oh, wait a minute! Let's not be hasty!
Hello? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Forever shut away
nothing lasts, nothing holds all of me. My heart's far, far away, home and
thank you.
news and listen all of my declarating.
My what a guy!
My what a guy!
Jeff
turning. Since I looked at that booty, yo man, and I promised myself I'll be married to Bel, and right now I'm evolving a plan.
Music.
Jean Charity, mademoiselle. It's with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull in the chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest, be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your neck and run your neck,
Siri, and we'll provide the rest.
Seducible, to nerves, but we only live to serve. Try to great stuff.
It's delicious!
Don't believe me? Ask the dishes, they can sing, they can dance.
After all, Miss, this is drunk.
And the dinner here is never so best. Go on a Voltron, then you take the glass. Then you'll be our guest, be our guest.
Be ragu, she's souffle, pie and pudding on Bombay.
We'll prepare and serve a flair of culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet is so complete. No one's gloomy or complaining while the flatware's entertaining.
We don't just.
I do tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste that you can make.
No stress is my dying to you suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
It's a guest, six alive, we'll all be blessed. Wine's been poured, and thank the Lord I've had the napkins for seacrest. With a cinch, you want tea, and my dear, that's fine with me. While the cups do their self-shooming, I'll be bubbling, I'll be brewing, I'll be warm, heaven's sake. We got a lot to do.
Oh, no.
Who are you, our guest?
She's our guest. She's our guest. She's our guest. We are guests. 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 Our command is your request. It's been years since we've had.
Oh, so that's the West Wing.
Nice go.
What are you doing in there? Sorry, I was just...
I thought I told you to never come here.
I know, but...
Do you realize where you lived on?
Sorry, I was just...
I thought... Get out.
Promise you no promise, I won't stay in this castle.
I'm sorry. No, I didn't mean to frighten you. You don't understand. There's so little left of me. So little left.
When she stopped to catch her breath, Belle heard the low and menacing growl of wolves.
One wolf charged at Belle head on. She grabbed him with branch to defend herself.
Suddenly, the beast leaped out of nowhere and pulled the wolves off of Belle.
Belle took cover as the wolves turned and attacked the beast.
One grabbed hold of the beast's forearm, wounding it.
He struggled to stand his feet.
Once the beast hurled the last wolf away, he collapsed, exhausted and in pain.
Belle knew that this was her chance to get away, to go home.
And she looked at the beast, that hideous creature who saved her. She couldn't leave.
Belle approached Beast to help him to his feet.
Belle and the Beast slowly made their way back to the castle.
Let me see, just hold still.
Ouch! That hurt!
If you hold still, it wouldn't hurt as much.
You had to run away, this was happening.
If you hadn't frightened me, I wouldn't run away.
Well, you should have been the one swing.
And you need to learn to control your temper. Now hold still, so I can sing a little.
Ouch!
And thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
That's more like it. I knew they could get along if they
tried.
Well, the ice is broken.
And after a moment too soon either. The rose has already begun to lose its petals. I shall no longer grace.
My heart
has been
over it all.
Then, I'll give them a little.
I have just the thing. How about we go up there with a nice cold soup?
Something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean, he was coarse, unrefined. But now he's dear, and so I'm sure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before.
Cheers!
Glances wave, I thought I saw, but when we touched, it didn't shudder at my fall. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me that way before. When she smiles at me, I get all choked up and my heart's just pounding and I can't breathe.
Good.
That's good?
Excellent.
I've never felt this way about anyone. I want to give her something, but what?
You see something special, something that sponsored.
Look who's back!
It's Brown?
I promise.
Oh, what a nice bow.
Thank you.
Belle, I have something I want to show you.
Books in my whole life.
Do you like it?
It's wonderful.
And it's yours.
Yeah.
guest on Hilly's secret meeting.
Like Mr. Brindle.
Thank you for coming out such a good time, Mr. Dark. Look, I have my heart stuck by you, though. She needs a little persuasion. It's like this, see?
let me go. That horrible beast let me go? He's not horrible. At first I was so frightened, I thought it was the end of everything, but somehow, things changed. Good afternoon. Monsieur Diac, I'm here to collect your father.
What?
Don't worry, though. Don't be a good
man. My father's not crazy.
It's a shame about your father.
Gaston, you know my father isn't crazy.
I may be able to clear this up if...
If what?
You marry me.
What?
One little word, though. That's all it takes.
Never.
Have it your way. Take no man.
Wait. I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast.
That's him! That's him!
Is he dangerous?
Oh, no, we'd never hurt anyone. I know he looks frightful, but he's really kind and... gentle, he's my friend.
If I say you better, if I didn't know better, I'd say you have feeling for this monster.
He's not a monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as old man. She says this monster is a friend. While hunting wild beasts, I see what it can do. The beast will make off with your children. We'll come back with it in the night.
He would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say we kill the beast.
Dad, he'll come stalking us at night.
He said to sacrifice our children to his monstrous appetites.
He'll wreak havoc on our village if we let him wander free.
So it's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow me. Through the mist, through the woods, through the darkness and the shadows, the night where it was more than sunny bright. They appeared, they were there, through the jarvis of the castle, there's something truly terrible inside.
It's a beast, he's a beast, raise a sharp one, and his claws, good claws for the beast.
Hear him roar, hear him foam, but we're not coming home
till he's dead, till he's dead.
Get out of the beast!
I won't let you do this.
Try and stop us.
Papa, this is all my fault. I have to go warn him.
Come in with you.
No.
Lost, he wants to.
We're in the village of the beast. Who's with me?
I am!
Cross the plains, grand as high, we go marching into the battle, but afraid although the dangers just increase. Bring the flag, sing the song, 50 come with 50 strong, and 50 friends, we can't be wrong.
Kill the beast! Kill the beast! Kill the beast! Kill the beast!
Waving torches and weapons.
Once gathered in front of the beast castle, they carefully made their way inside.
From today, this is all that I need.
I love you.
Yay!
feel free to get your pictures right now. It's a great opportunity. We are so thankful that you are here to witness really history for Kernan. You know, Kernan's been open 20 years, and this is the first musical that the school's ever put on. They come from all over the school, you know, they do all kinds of different things. They're involved in a lot of things, and we've asked them to do a lot this year. And we're super, super thankful for them, but also for you in the audience. You're the ones that sacrifice, you know, you're the ones that bring them to practice. You're the ones that put up with them learning their lines and learning the songs when they don't sound so good. So we're super, super thankful for you. A couple people that we really want to thank, a program like this, especially in its infancy, is impossible to pull off without a great administration. And we're super blessed here at Kernan to have a great administration. Galliani here in the front, and Ms. Kelch, and our entire administrative team. Again, I can't speak highly enough. There are schools in the area that are choosing to get rid of the arts, and while that's happening, Kernan is choosing to double down.
Thank you.